Welcome to the Defensive Guide on Pug. Today, we'll be joined by PogChamp1, and we're going to be going over what defensive is, and why it's important, and basically how to play it. Now, before we start, I just want to offer a quick disclaimer that this guide is assuming that you have a fair amount of knowledge about the game, and that you have a decent understanding about every single character. Now, let's get into the defensive video. Oh, and real quick, I just want to say a huge thank you to Anchor Falls for editing this video, because this project has been draining me so much with editing, and with Anchor helping me by editing this video, it takes so much off my hands. So once again, thank you so much to Anchor. Can we get a Pog Anchor Falls in the comments? So, Pog. First thing I want to ask you is, what is defensive pug? Like, why should you play defensive pug over any other playstyle?
Well, in theory, it's pretty much the best way to play this game is to play defensive. If you're not playing against ranged characters, with a character like pug, it becomes really easy to like outdo your enemy because of your movement. And if the enemy is gonna run into you, you have a bork, and bork does 10 damage. It's a really strong ability. So if you can just bait your enemy to walk into you, you can punish them really effectively.
Okay, now when would it be a good idea to play defensive?
Defensive is a really like wide range. You can play like off the edge, or even be considered to like hide from an ultimate. I guess that you can call that defensive. The important thing is that you know that you can't just stand behind a wall the entire game, because you're not being proactive. You're not doing anything, you're just kind of being annoying. If your enemy has the advantage, you can play defensive. Yeah, it is against most melee heroes, yeah. Because you have to play aggro against, like, Skullfire or, like, Hood.
And meanwhile, a character like Mara, if you just constantly approach the Mara, you're just gonna drain all your health.
You can pretty much, like, outstyle a Mara if you have, like, really fast movement. But the safest way to play it is just to play defensive and bait out the grip.
So basically, defensive is the safest playstyle.
If I see you over there, I kind of have two choices. Either I go really aggressive on you, or I just stay back and wait for you to come at me, and then I can bork when you come at me. Like that. So it's kind of hard for you to do anything right now, because I'm just like, you're walking into everything I do, right? And that's why this is kind of easy to play in a sentence, because you're just kind of like, they're just kind of walking into your abilities. The way to play defensive really is just like to walk back, pressing S if you do that. Play in where the enemy is not and like at the edge of the map, that's defensive. And not running at them, that's defensive.
Okay, so I'd like to add on to that just a little bit. I would say defensive is mainly you're trying to bait your opponent and making sure that you're not the one to approach. When you're playing defensive, it's a lot easier for you to hit stuff, while it's a lot harder for your enemy to.
Yeah, because I'm walking into the stuff that you do.
If they start to approach and they use an ability like that, then you can push a tiny aggro moment, and that's kind of a mixture of hit and run with defensive. Okay, so the next point that I want to cover is countering the enemy. So, countering the enemy is the most important thing about defensive pug. What you kind of want to be doing is you want to adjust to their movement. So, just kind of watch how they move. Like, what are they trying to accomplish? Like, you see Pog goes in the air a lot, so Pog is maybe trying to make himself appear threatening, and then do something like that where he tries to approach when you're not expecting it. So now that I know how he's gonna play, I kind of want to base my playstyle around countering that. Like being ready to press the S key when you see him even slightly press the W key.
You want to get a feeling for how your enemy plays the game, because if the enemy is also playing defensive, you kind of have to reconsider you playing defensive. Even though they might have the advantage on you, you know what they're doing. And if you know how to play defensive, you might also know how to counter it. Because if you see the enemy, for an example, like always doing this, you can just bork them as they're coming down and then punish it. Or if you see your enemy is doing this a lot, when he's doing like the movement tech and whatever, you know where it's gonna end up, right? so you can punish that.
Yeah, and I think predicting is a big part of defensive pug. Defensive is called a lot of times the lame playstyle, and basically sometimes it's okay to play lame. Like, for instance, if the enemy is a marauder, or if they're like a sergeant,
void, exactly.
A class that would easily outdamage you. You want to be able to play in a way that you're ready to bait them at any time, and then especially if they try to approach you, when you play defensive, you can equal out that trade. Whereas if you were trying to go aggro, you would just get destroyed by any sort of half-good void. All right, so I just want to describe when you want to make a move as defensive. So you're typically just kind of staying back. Now you're waiting on, let's say we're fighting a void crawler. You're waiting on them to waste their teleboom or for them to try to approach you. And then that's when you want to make some kind of move to deal damage. Like, he's gonna miss his teleboom here, trying to approach me. And now, I'm good to go aggro, and we can trade left and right clicks. But if I hit the Bork, that means I out-trade the Void Crawler. But you have to keep in mind that you don't want to be going aggro for too long as defensive.
Now that playing defensive against the Void is always good, what do you do if the Void is also playing defensive? If a melee hero like Void or Mara is playing defensive, you don't want to rush at them like you do with any like ranged character. You want to like approach but bait the teleboom at the same time and then hit them with a Bork if they come at you. So if I'm playing defensive right now, you can like come at me but hold S. Like when I'm going for a teleboom right there, I saw you were going in and then I went for a teleboom but I missed because you pressed S.
I was trying to trick him into saying, hey, I am in teleboom range. But in reality, the second that I would press S, I would go out of that teleboom range. He's gonna miss the teleboom. And even if he hits his dash, I still would outdamage him because I predicted him using that teleboom with my bait.
The best way to do it is just on a map like circled, you can like hide behind the massive thing in the middle and then you can bait them off of that.
And I mean, a map like this works pretty well because you could use these walls. Like, let's say that the Mara is on top of this wall before it was destroyed. You can kind of jump up to this wall and you can make him think that he can hit that grip. But then the second that he would go for the grip, I would be moving in towards the wall. And right here, not only has he wasted his grip, but he is also in Bork range. This is going to be expanded on later, but honestly, one of the most important parts for even just playing Smash levels in general is you want to be using the map. In this situation, Voidcrawler standing there, what I could do is I could rush to this wall, and that would make it so either I'm going to hit the teleboom on the Voidcrawler, or he's going to think that he can use his teleboom right here where I was. And so not only have you baited him one way, but you've also baited him a second way. And so that's a really important thing to go for.
The movement usage is kind of like, it's not just for defensive, it's just overall movement kind of thing. So I'm just gonna touch on it. You can use right click, shift, space, space. That can be used for like running away from ults or hiding from something, or just going into a defensive spot. You really want to know when your enemy has a cooldown and not. For an example, if the Mara uses grip, that's your time to shine. If the Void uses teleboom, you go in. If the clock uses his cluster buck, you can go in without any problems at all. And that's going to really benefit you.
You want to kind of keep an internal tracker on like how much time has passed. Like, for instance, once you've been fighting for like a minute, you know, you're gonna be pretty close to ult, or one of you two are, and so then you're gonna be kind of waiting for that ult.
So when they have ult, you play more conservative. You don't commit fully, because if you do that, they're gonna get an easy ult on you.
So you kind of want to keep an eye on like when it would be a good time for you to ult, because they wouldn't have a counterplay, and also when you don't want to fully commit to things, you can still like deal some damage, but you don't want to put yourself in a vulnerable spot to just get massive ulted on. Welcome to off the map pug.
So this is also kind of the baiting thing, because if your opponent's playing pug, for instance, and they're coming at you like this way, This is really, it's kind of hard to like escape from here if they have an angle on you. So you can like back off here and then like hit them with the Bork as they're walking towards you.
Right as they approach you, you're going to hold the Esky, you'll hit the Bork, and you'll kind of stay down for a moment and let them kind of sit by the wall because you can get free damage here.
If I try to kill you when you are laying down there, I can't hit you. I can't hit you.
Okay, and when you're fighting a pug, both of you are playing a game of not only your X and Z, but you also need to watch your Y, because when you're below them, you can hit them easier, but you also have an easier chance to get spiked. So you kind of want to be going between above and below them based off of what is happening. A lot of the times it's better just to be below them, but at the same time, you have to be watching your health. You have to be watching if you're able to get spiked or what you can do to avoid a spike. And then of course, when you go above them, you have to be wondering, all right, what can I do to spike him? Such as that, I just borked him straight down. And now he has to use extra energy and he's out of energy. That's a big thing. Energy management is more used off the map than if you were to use it on the map.
I kind of want to have this out there that if you're gonna play off the edge, you have to prioritize cooldowns. You have to use your dash the most often you can, and then your energy, and lastly your double jumps.
Okay, so the next topic that I want to talk about is positioning. Let's say that the pug is sitting up here. Now, for positioning, you don't want to go like this, because while that may be a little bit unpredictable, it's just not the best play. Like, why would you put yourself in range of getting hit yourself when you could easily just do that? And then other situations, let's say you're right here, the other pug is right over there on that platform. Now, what can you do to position the best? Well, first of all, I'd say you want to change the positioning, because you don't really want to be in this situation, because it's that whole game of baiting, but neither of you have any space to work from. So let's say you don't want to be here, so you're deciding, all right, I want to move somewhere else. I want to change the scenery. So maybe you want to kind of move over here, or maybe you just want to move up here. And then now that you're up here, you have a better view of where your opponent is. And so now your opponent wants to hit you going up this wall. You can kind of predict that coming. So let's say you see the pug start moving to the wall. Now you can dash to the side and then maybe go around and then punish from the back end.
So as we covered before, defensive has like a really long range. You know, there's a lot of things that are defensive in this game. And one of these things are using cooldowns defensive, and especially your ult can be very defensive used. For an example, if I'm gonna go in like this, you see me going in, you can just ult as I come in and I'm just running into mini pugs.
Yeah, and now he has no energy to be able to get himself out because he used all that trying to approach. And even if they did save a little bit of energy, that still, they've taken 10, 20 damage from that, plus your own combo.
Even an attempt, you think they're gonna go at you, it's not the end of the world. The point is that they use cooldowns to get to you, and you punish that by ulting.
To summarize it up, defensive pug is probably one of the best, or at least the safest options to play against like melee heroes. It works against some hybrid heroes depending on their class in general.
If it's a cryo, you don't want to consider defensive much at all. You have the advantage because of their lack in mobility, but like Karakot, you kind of like don't want to play defensive or aggro. So you want to play more hit and run against Karakot. Because if you're playing defensive, you're just gonna get hit from the edge of the map. And if you're playing too aggro, you're gonna take a lot of hits.
And then as far as defensive itself, defensive is basically just trying to bait your opponent and just staying back, making sure that you don't have to approach and you're letting them approach you. And like I said, a big thing for honestly all of Smash, but it really works with defensive pug as well, is getting to know how your enemy moves, like what they're going to do against you. And then you also want to make sure that you're keeping a track of what cooldowns they're using. Like if they use Bork, it's a good time that you can go ahead and go in. And if they have like their smash and you don't have yours, you want to be kind of staying back and waiting for them to use it. You're ready to just go ahead and run and get out of there as quick as possible. Well, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope this helped you at least a little bit to learn how to play defensive and why it's important. And on Friday, we'll be going over hit and run, and we'll be featuring Anchor Falls with that one. Thank you guys once again for watching the video. I'll see you guys in the next video. See ya!